Okay. Kobe doing work. 2-4 on my shirt. He the greatest on the court, and I'm the greatest on the verse. Going for the fourth ring like it was his first. Gotta get the gleam. Do it for Kareem. 2-4 so nice. My flow so mean. Catch me at the game, sitting next to Goldstein. Kobe Bryant Nikes, purple gold strings. Kobe in the game, dunking on
the whole team.
Black Mamba, attack conquer. Basketball beast, rap monster. Crossover good, a turnaround jumper. I'll just drive the lane and dunk on dunkers. You know where it's going, it's going down, yo. This is the lake show, but don't drown, though. I call him King Bryant, not let the crown show.
Black Lives Matter fact, as a matter of fact.
Let's meet the visiting team, Los Angeles Lakers. At small forward, Rui Hachimura. At shooting guard, Austin Reeves. At the other guard position, D'Angelo Russell. At center, Anthony Davis. At the other forward position, LeBron James. The head coach of the visiting team is Darvin Ham.
Positions, Russell and Reeves. Down in the block, it's LeBron and Davis. And it's Hachimura in at the small forward position. And for New Orleans, Ingram at the three with Williamson playing the four. In the backcourt, it's McCollum and Jones. And it's Valanciunas in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And we know, Greg, most of the talk coming into this game focused on the front court matchup. A lot of talent in the low post here.
And, you know, a lot of times that means it'll come down to the rebounding battle. Whoever controls the boards will have a big leg up in the physical and mental aspect of this game.
McCollum kicks to Valanciunas. Back to McCollum. Pass to Jones. Just five on the clock. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
A high second-round pick. Herb Jones has done a nice job turning himself into a rotational piece.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
Two shots.
Yeah. first one falls for. And so Jones nails both of them.
We've seen him put a lot of pressure on the defense and then cash in at the line.
On the wing, James. Covered by Williamson. LeBron passes to Reeves. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. Davis against Valanciunas. Here's Hachimura. No good on the triple. Williamson looking it over. No good that time. LeBron with some nice deep. And here's James. He'll bring it up for L.A. And talking about LeBron James, Steve, he still is on the hunt for more championships.
Kevin, that hunger is still evident. LeBron James. He's all about finishing his career on a strong note, which includes winning as many titles as possible.
Here's McCollum following the basket by LeBron James. That's good from Williamson on the assist by McCollum.
We talk about Zion's strength, but the body control is also elite, especially for a guy his size.
Here's Reeves. The rebound by Brandon Ingram.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
The rim protection at its finest. The result is the same whether you block the shot or simply change it.
Well, you like how aggressive he is making a play at the rim against Flint.
And let's forget the height disadvantage. He brings the effort and he brings the energy.
Now here's LeBron, one of the most consistent producers in the league. He's averaging around 25 and a half points a game. Hachimura, the pass to Reeves for the three. Here's Davis. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's on Jonas Valanciunas.
Got to be careful how you guard Davis. Given his size, he uses it to absorb contact.
Lakers shooting their first shots of the night from a charity stripe. Throw good, Davis. And for his size, and Steve, when healthy, Anthony Davis is as agile and mobile as they come.
That's his secret sauce, Kevin. He has great size and skill, but his ability to move like a guard really separates him from other bigs.
And both free throws good for Davis.
Because he knows he makes a living at the line, he invites contact and sometimes even initiates it.
And here's McCollum for three. Connects from three-point range. McCollum's got five now.
Such a talented offensive player. CJ is dangerous from deep.
And a wide-open look for James. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back. 3 points.
Matching baskets from the perimeter, an earmark of today's game.
Hey, players love competition, and the fans love it as well.
Now here's Ingram. Scheming at 13. Good work there as it goes.
I mean, beautiful execution of the game plan offensively. So far, they are hitting 80% from the field.
McCollum against Russell. Now the pass to Hachimura. Here's Reeves. He dishes it to Davis. Lays it up off the glass.
Exceptional timing on the pick and roll. AD showing a good feel for how to generate points.
McCollum kicks to Williamson. Oh, he just jams it right over LeBron. Wow.
With the reputation of a highlight reel dunker, Zion's always ready to put on a show.
And that last look brought to you by the AT&T 5G Slam King.
Timeout.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here.
And, Smitty, you think about the years McCollum played with Damian Lillard. You have to believe they made each other better.
I totally agree, G.A. They both have high standards, always working on their games. That's why they're two of the best guards in the league over the last decade.
A big group substitution here for New Orleans. Nancy's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Marshall comes in for Zion Williamson. Trey Murphy's checked in for Brandon Ingram. And Hawkins subbed in for Herbert Jones. And there it is for him.
The defense late to react. A beautiful play we just saw.
Hawkins kicks to Marshall. Pass to McCollum. Over Vincent.
2 minutes.
It's rebounded by Haynes.
Wow, that's one you just kind of assume is going in. Tough luck.
Defended by Vincent. Passes it to Nance. 13 feet away, and they pick up two.
And how about the job Nance has done to try to make himself into a more consistent offensive threat?
Vincent finds Prince. Kicks it out to Dinwiddie. Over Hawkins, cloaked loose. Here's Prince. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up two.
Torian Prince takes the hit, maintains focus. He's a tough individual.
And he's going up for the alley-oop. And so the ball out of bounds. McCollum touched it last.
Careless turnover. You lose focus for even a moment in this league. That's the result.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. Vincent, the pass to Dinwiddie. And he hits it to tie the game up.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
And here's McCollum. He had 25 points last game. Puts it up. Shot is good off the back rim and in.
Terrific play. This is why you run your offense through him and live with the results.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. On its way from Dinwiddie for two. And again, it's the Lakers.
Boy, both teams racking up the points to start this game.
And you wonder how long they can keep it going. At some point, you expect the defense will adjust.
Dinwiddie with it. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. Inside. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Well, that is why we call CJ a combo guard. He can score with the best, but he also can facilitate.
Oh, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. Pelicans ahead. They lead by 4. From New Orleans, back in a moment. And we welcome you back to the second quarter of this exciting play-in game. And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Pelicans.
Right out of the gate, they've been in attack mode. And I think that's by design because it has been relentless.
And also, they're doing something you don't see as much anymore, and that is converting time and time again from the mid-range.
Underneath, in the post, it's Williamson and Valanciunas. Sharing the wing spots, it's Jones and Ingram. And it's Alvarado at the 1. That's the Pelicans' 5. Alvarado passes to Valanciunas. He kicks it to Ingram. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
James, the bounce pass. to the middle. Here's Russell.
And that's pro. Russell gets his man a little out of position and draws the foul.
Lakers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Shooting for Los Angeles, D'Angelo Russell at the line for two.
The first free throw is good. So Russell hits them both. New Orleans in the lead. Outside, Jones. Valanciunas again to Davis. No good from Valanciunas.
And that is the exact type of opportunity this offense is looking to create.
You know, if you get the ball to the right guy in the right spot, more often than not, you're coming away with points.
Davis gets rebounded by New Orleans.
Even though he missed it, this is the exact play your offense is designed to produce.
Alvarado passes to Williamson. It drops for his third basket. He's missed only one shot.
Defensively, you have to deny Williamson, not allowing him to bring it inside. He's too good around the rim.
Hey, Smitty, you want to talk about explosiveness? This is your man, Zion Williamson.
Kevin, I mean, when he was in college, he blew through a shoe making a cut. He's so strong, Kevin, the leather couldn't hold up.
That's it, and the Pelican lead is cut down to two on the bucket from Reeves.
Now that's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
Reason why, it takes extra energy to do it. You have to trust your defensive rotations, but it's worth it.
Alvarado with it. He's picked up by James. And it's Alvarado missing.
Great focus on the defensive end there to contest that shot.
And this is where you would prefer to work the ball to someone else for just a better look.
They're going to have to come up with a better matchup. This guy just too much speed.
And first time out of the game called for New Orleans.
And coaches looking to seize every advantage, maximize every possession.
Critical part of the game. You have to be flexible. You have to be able to adjust what you're doing.
And so it's Williamson who brings up the ball for the New Orleans Pelicans. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
And it's coming easy for them right now. Five baskets in a row in the paint.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
First personal foul. First team foul. At the line for your Pelicans, Zion Williamson.
That free throw good from Williamson.
Certainly goes to the line a lot. A spot where Williamson would like to become more efficient.
Russell finds Hachimura. Russell left side. Shoots over Alvarado. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Second personal.
I like the awareness. Excellent position. Beautiful job working off the pick.
Shooting for
this will be his third free throw shot of the game.
D'Angelo Russell at the line for one.
Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Here's Alvarado. He's guarded by Russell from deep. And the basket by Alvarado. And the Pelicans lead by three.
Over the taller defender. This is why you have to stay connected to shooters on the perimeter.
And let's give him some credit. He read the situation well. He created some space and he delivered.
Alvarado with the steal. takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. And it's a five-point Pelican lead for Los Angeles. They've gotten four of their first five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooter. Pass to Reeves. Hits the three-point bomb. Reeves has got 5 points so far.
And I like Russell's ability to create for others. He does what's best for the team.
Whistle blows, basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. A big group substitution here for New Orleans. Zeller, he's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Trey Murphy comes in for Williamson. Hawkins checked in for Herbert Jones. And it's C.J. McCollum in for Jose Alvarado. A big group substitution here for the Lakers. Jackson Hayes, he's checked in for Anthony Davis. Prince comes in for Rui Hachimura. Radish, he's checked in for Austin Reeves. And it's Gabe Vincent in for D'Angelo Russell.
It's so fun to see Brandon Ingram evolve. He's a true student of the game, and each year he keeps improving.
And how about the incredible timing on that alley-oop?
He absolutely hammered it down. Smitty will remember this date, February 8th, 2023, a very special night. LeBron passing Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the all-time scoring list.
Kevin, that record is a testament to LeBron's will. He takes incredible care of his body. At 20 years in, LeBron James still playing at a high level.
Now here's Hayes. Back to LeBron. To the inside. And Hayes throws it down.
Hard to stop even when you know it's coming. LeBron waits for just the right moment, delivers the perfect pass.
Now a timeout called by New Orleans.
On your feet, make some noise with those hands together for your Pelicans dance team. That was your Pelicans. Let's hear it one more time.
There's 1:17 left in the first half. Now Zeller, no scoring in this one. Ingram with it. Wanted now by Prince. Yes, that goes in. Ingram's got the lead up to six now for the Pelicans.
There's B.I. using his length inside. Impressive finish.
Vincent the pass to Reddish. Now here's Hayes. He's covered by Zeller. Vincent down to five on the shot clock, and it's Brandon Ingram with the foul.
Brandon,
that's his first foul. Larry Nance has checked in for Brandon Ingram. Dinwiddie has checked in for Los Angeles.
Substitution on the court.
Here's Prince. 9 points last game out. Six to shoot. Here's Vincent. He is guarded by McCollum. Vincent misses.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have to have the confidence to take that shot. Might not always fall.
You know what another option is? Just give the ball up. Let someone else make a play.
Here's Dinwiddie. Cans it from short range.
Spencer Dinwiddie.
Dinwiddie's got his third basket of the night right there. McCollum outside. It's good. And the Pelicans lead by eight.
When McCollum is putting it all together on offense, it is fun to watch. Bourne score.
Yep, that one goes.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
And so it's the New Orleans Pelicans with a six-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shots. A lot of good shots. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. AD, you see how they're playing you in the first half. What's the adjustment going to be?
So you know, we got to come out with a great intensity, and it starts in warm-up. So we got to come out with a great intensity, great mindset, and try to go out there and win the third quarter.
I have never heard anyone say it starts in warm-ups until now. Thanks, AD. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith.
C.J. McCollum was on fire in the first half. He had 12 points, 3 assists, and 1 steal. It's been quite a night so far for him. Kenny, your thoughts, how the Pelicans are playing?
Well, I like what I'm seeing on the offensive end. They're keeping things simple, getting to their spots, and executing. Nothing fancy. Kind of like Shaq's suit.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Lakers?
Right now, they're playing well only on one end of the court. All their energy has been spent on the defensive end. And that's a change. They're just going to keep giving up easy buckets, and the game's going to get away from them.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
And welcome to the second half of this high-stakes play-in clash. You know, C.J. McCollum has been exceptional here, guys.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
So the Lakers five right now. Down in the block, it's LeBron and Davis. At the guard positions, Russell and Reeves, and it's Hachimura in at the three spot. Count that one.
Anthony
Davis has got the first basket of the second half here for the Lakers.
Not enough to affect Davis's shot. It'll take more than that.
McCollum kicks to Jones. Valanciunas inside. Davis is there. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. That's on D'Angelo Russell.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the ball.
Pelicans shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
C.J. McCollum.
Throw good, McCollum.
C.J. McCollum is the kind of player any team would love to have. He does so many things well.
And so McCollum nails both of them. Lakers trailed by 6. James looking around. No good. Shot missing. Good D by Williamson. Now the dish to McCollum. Davis against Valanciunas. Over Davis. No good from Valanciunas.
He operates well in traffic, but still, that's just a tough play to finish.
Looking at the veteran, Jonas Valanciunas, Steve, he remains a nightly double-double threat.
He's someone that likes to flex his muscle on both ends, Kevin. A big man who uses his size to his advantage and is reliable at cashing in from inside.
Now a timeout called by New Orleans. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
Williamson with it, picked up by Davis. And here is Ingram. 9 points in the game so far. Fade away. That misses off the backboard.
And really, that is why he is feared as a defender, right in your face on that shot.
Moved his feet, timed it perfectly. That's how you get stops. Love it.
Jones kicks to Williamson. There's the pass to McCollum. Reeves with the rebound.
They have yet to hit a shot. A real slow start here in the second half.
Here's James, and the Lakers check on two more. James.
Everything going to plan here to start the third. 80% shooting thus far.
Pass to Valanciunas. Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. Clock at six. New Orleans needs to get off a shot. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Davis has got rebound number 5 here tonight.
Missed 4 straight shots now. At one point, do you have to call a timeout and regroup?
Williamson outside. And Davis sends it back.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebound advantage is starting to add up.
Oh, LeBron's just too strong inside.
He's given a great lift to this offense tonight. Very, very efficient.
Ingram against Hachimura. Looking to end the run, and Ingram lays it in. Ingram's got it all tied up now for the Pelicans.
Nimble ball handling by Ingram, allowing him to beat the D and find his shot.
Hachimura with it. Now Valanciunas defending. McCollum against Russell. McCollum dishes to Ingram. New Orleans moving the ball around. McCollum up top. He's guarded by Russell. McCollum no good. Lakers have gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field. And there's the call on Zion Williamson. That is his first foul of the game. Some changes for New Orleans. Najee Marshall, he's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. And it's Jose Alvarado in for McCollum. Here's Hayes. Passes it to Reddish. Over in the corner, Vincent. Williamson with the block.
Get used to seeing blocks like that from Zion. Man, he's sending that one back.
Just no resistance inside at all. They are feasting. This is a straight buffet.
It is. It's a big one. And load the plate. It's Ingram on the wing. Yes, once again, it remains perfect. 6 attempts and 6 hits.
His performance today has just been so important. What a luxury to have a guy that's that dependable.
Pass to Hayes. Kicks it to Reddish. Shot clock at 6. Shoots over Ingram. And good. As it just snugs right down through the net.
That's a quick shot released by Cam Reddish. If you're the defense, it's hard to contest that one.
Jones, the pass to Ingram. Williamson outside. Down low. Up and in on the layup. Williamson's got 11 points.
Muscling through the contact, Zion getting assertive.
The Lakers have gone 7 of 11, a lucky field goal percentage here in the third. And he lobs it up toward the rim.
Oh, can we get a load of that one? Take that play and put it in the alley-oop textbook, boys.
Perfectly done. You're right. He put it on a platter for him. Shot and game clock separated by 5. Ingram passes to Alvarado. It's deflected. And Zinn with it. 6 points for him. Here's Dinwiddie. Hayes dishes to Dinwiddie. Misses the baby hook.
I'm a bit shocked, honestly, that he misses that. That's his shot in rhythm.
And at the close of the third quarter, still in post game, and both teams putting up points in a hurry. Lakers lead by two. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. And how about a look now at our assist of the game, brought to you by State Farm.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here, looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
Yeah, it's one thing to find the guy. It's another to deliver the ball where he can do something with it. Wonderful play.
Let's go. It's a tight one.
And we're back, a lot on the line for this playing game with 1 quarter left to go. Underneath, in the post, it's Williamson and Valanciunas. Cohen is out there with Hawkins. So that's the group out there for New Orleans. McCollum outside. Releases. And it's good off the back of the rim and in. McCollum's got the game tied up here for New Orleans. And so James will bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. And there's the pass to Russell. Back to LeBron. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. James has got the lead up to three now for the Lakers.
The three-pointer is a much bigger part of LeBron's game. He's not shy from outside.
Here's Williamson, and it's in. Basket number six for him thus far. He has only missed two shots from the floor.
And that's right in his wheelhouse, looking to make an impact when it counts.
It's the fourth quarter, and it's a close game. You want to get the ball to someone you can rely on.
And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for one more.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working inside and getting good shots from close range.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
They are dominating the paint in this one. Consistent work inside throughout the game.
And you can't ignore their passing. All game long, they've done a great job of just delivering the ball in rhythm right where it needs to be.
Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Pass to Hawkins. New Orleans moving the ball around. Left side, Nance. McCollum outside. Tipped away. It's stolen by Davis. Now the Lakers on the break. Puts it up for Davis. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
What a beautiful play. And it was great timing. Then the athletic finish by AD.
This is it to Davis. Drills the three-pointer.
Defensively, you can't back off him that much. You don't want to give up easy threes at this stage of the game.
Russell passes to Davis. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. Russell's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Now Hawkins. On the wing, Nance. The tray. And again, New Orleans with the triple.
And coming down the stretch here, both teams still on fire.
Yes. And if you love offense, you're loving this matchup. It's been a highlight reel affair.
And James gets it to go.
No question, James has the green light from anywhere. That mid-range is just another area where he's dangerous.
McCollum, good on the shot. McCollum's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And you want him taking big shots for you in big moments. That one was as easy as it gets.
And I don't think he expected to get that good of a look. Poor communication defensively.
Russell passes to Hachimura. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
One thing we can say about Hachimura, he is not afraid of the challenge.
McCollum outside, pass to Hawkins. To the wing right side. Shot clock at 5. Top of the key. And all around the rim that time before dropping in.
And so far in the second half, this has been a different kind of game than what we saw early on.
And this half, a more entertaining one. The pace has picked up, tougher defense, better ball movement.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
You have to make it harder for him to score. Deny the ball, even double, whatever it takes to force someone else to beat you.
And now we present our New Balance Player of the Game, LeBron James.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. That has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Guys, here's what Willie Green was doing in reviewing the plan with his team. Now, he talked about keeping confidence. He said, this game is close, but we know we're the better team. Now it's time to go out there and prove it. See if they can come back in this one, guys.
All right, thank you, David. LeBron dishes to Davis. And the rejection by Valanciunas.
Those are the plays you want from Valanciunas on the defensive end. Didn't hesitate to challenge the shot.
And that's a lesson for the D. Fight harder on the glass.
Reason why, lack of focus, lack of communication, which led to second chance points. Hey, this is what you want out of your max guys. Ingram stepping up in the moment.
James with it. Now Valanciunas defending. And it's Davis with the jam.
And the passer floated it up to the precise spot it needed to be.
And no messing around on the finish. He powers it through. Valanciunas trying to free himself up. Ingram can't get that one to fall. Lakers leading by 6. James slams it in.
LeBron is playing well. The ageless wonder.
And so it's Ingram who brings up the ball for New Orleans. The pass to Valanciunas. Williamson kicks to Ingram. Shoots over Hachimura. And it's LeBron James with the rebound.
The defense is right there. Quality contest, and they threw him off his rhythm. Yeah, he's kicking himself. No defenders to be found in that mid-range area.
LeBron against Ingram. A fadeaway. And it's LeBron James with the rebound.
Right idea, but just too much heat on him defensively, even with the fadeaway.
16 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one.
They just blocked out the noise, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
And guess what? It's going to be a fun flight home. Total team effort. Big win on the road. He has to show real leadership out there and take this game into his own hands because he's shooting the ball well.
Here's Reeves. And they did it, folks. Big win for the Los Angeles Lakers. A narrow win under difficult circumstances, Greg, as the visiting team.
It really was, but that didn't seem to bother them. I mean, road team, home team, all I know is they were the better team.
Well said. And now, let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline for our player of the game. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. LeBron, in the fourth quarter, were you looking to be aggressive?
Yeah, just try to close the game out. You know, my teammates looked for me in the fourth quarter to close the game out with my scoring and just my playmaking ability. So, you know, to be able to go out there and come through for it means a lot.
I know they're used to it by now, but I know you're still happy with the win. Congrats. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll wrap this one up. No shortage of excitement here in the play-in tournament. For Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. We'll see you later.